Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Nurul Aisyah Miti Muhammad Amin and my matrix number is 1200871. So for today, I would like to present to you about the chapter of interest. So first of all, we will go through the definition of interest. What is interest? Firstly, interest is how much is paid for the use of money. Either it will be as a person or an amount. In other words, interest is a payment of the use of service of capital, and it is usually expressed as percent per annum. Interest is divided into money earned by investor when money is invested. Secondly, the charge incurred by the borrower when a loan or credit is obtained. For more information, interest calculated non-original principal for the entire period that was invested or borrowed. Let's take a look for the example of interest. So the situation is Alif wants to borrow RM1,000 and the bank says Alif need to pay 10% of interest. So this is what happened. Today, the bank will give Alif 1,000. But next year, Alif must pay the 1,000 to the bank and plus the interest with 10% RM100. So there are two types of interest, which is simple interest and compound interest. Next, let's take a look at the formula of simple interest. The formula is I equal to PRT, where I is the simple interest, P stand for principal or investment, R stand for rate per year, and T stand for time in years. Let's take a look at the example question of simple interest. So the question is, RM1000 is invested at 2 years in a bank, earning a simple interest rate of 8% per annum. Determine the simple interest earned. So the solution, we will use the formula, which is I equal to PRT, where P is 1000, R is 8%, or we will make it into decimal point, which is 0.08, and T is the time in years, which is 2 years. So I equal to PRT 1000 times by 0.08 and times by 2 equal to 160. Next, let's take a look at the definition of compound interest. Compound interest computation is based on the principal, which changes from time to time. And also, interest that is earned is compounded and or converted into principal and earns interest thereafter. So the formula of compounded interest is S equal to P times 1 plus I, which is I equal to R per M and to the power of N. So N is M times to T, where S equal to the compound amount, P is stand for original principal, M stand for frequency of conversion, and R for nominal interest rate per year, and lastly T equal to investment period. So now we will go through the example of compound interest. The question given are determine the future value of RM1000, which was invested for 4 years at 4% compounded annually. So the solution, we will use the formula of compounded interest. P equal to 1000, R equal to 4%, M equals to 1, T equal to 4 years, I equal to 4% over 1 equals to 1, N equals to 1 times 4 is 4. So S equal to 1000 times by 1 plus 4% to the power of 4. The answer that we will get is RM1169.86. So in compound interest, we have effective rate. So effective rate is simple interest that will produce the same accumulated amount in 1 year as the nominal rate compounded in times a year. The formula of effective rate is R equal to 1 plus R over M to the power of M minus 1, where REFF equals to effective rate of interest, M equals to frequency of conversion, and R equals to nominal interest rate per year. So, that's all from me about interest. Thank you.
So now, let's proceed to the present value. So present value is the current value of a future sum of money. So the formula is PV equals to C divided by 1 plus I to the power of N, which the PV is the present value, C is the future value or principal, I is the interest rate, and lastly, N is the number of period. So now let's look at the sample calculation. So the question is, find the present value of 1,000 ringgit due after 3 years if the interest rate is 9% compounded annually. Compounded annually means we pay the interest one time per year. So the solution is, first we put the formula, which is PV equals to C divided by 1 plus I to the power of N. And then C is the 1,000, 0.09 would be the interest rate or I, 3 would be the N, which is number of period. So we put all the figure in the formula, which is 1,000 divided by 1 plus 0.09 to the power of 3. So we get the present value 772.18. This means that 772.18% must be invested at the 9% compounded annually to have 1,000 in 3 years. Okay, next, we also have net present value, or known as NPV. It's defined as the sum of the present values of the cash flows minus the initial payment. Before this, for the present value, we bring in the payment just one time. Means all the payment must be made one off through the year. But for the NPV, the payment would be bring in at future time, which called as cash flow. So the formula is NPV equals to C1 divided by 1 plus I to the power of 1 plus C2 divided by 1 plus I to the power of 2, and so on, minus the initial payments. So C is the cash flows, R is the interest rate. So for our information, if the NPV more than zero, which is we get a positive figure, the investment would be profitable. But if the NPV is less than zero, which means a negative figure, the investment is not profitable at all. So now let's look at the question. Suppose that you can invest 20,000 ringgit in a business that guarantees you cash flow at the end of years 2, 3 and 5. As indicated in the table given. Assume an interest rate of 7% compounded annually and find the NPV of the cash flow. So the solution is, the first we put the formula and then we insert the figure given into the formula. So C is the cash flow, which is 10,000, 8,000 and 6,000. And then the N, we put the years, which is 2, 3 and 5. So calculation is NPV equals to 10,000 divided by 1 plus 0.7 to the power of 2 plus 8,000 divided by 1 plus 0.7 to the power of 3 plus 6,000 divided by 1 plus 0.7 to the power of 5 minus 20,000, which is the initial payment. So the NPV we get negative 457.31. So this investment is not profitable as the NPV is less than zero, which is negative. If we get negative, it means the investment is not profitable.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Nadira binti Muhammad Amran and my matrix number is 120081. So now I'm going to explain about future value, and I'm going to cover the meaning of future value, types of future value and some of example. First and foremost, what is future value? Future value is the value of current asset at a future date based on assumed rate of growth. The future value is really, really important to investors and financial planners, as they use it to estimate how much an investment made today will be worth in the future. Knowing the future value enables investors to make sound investment decisions based on their anticipated needs. However, external economic factors such as inflation can adversely affect the future value of the asset by eroding its value. The future value calculation allows investors to predict, with varying degrees of accuracy, the amount of profit that can be generated by different investments, and the amount of growth generated by holding a given amount in cash will likely be different than if that same amount were invested in stocks. Therefore, the future value equation is used to compare multiple options. There are a few different versions of the future value formula, but at its most basic, the equation looks like this. Future value equals to present value times with 1 plus interest rate, the power of n. Condensed into math lingo, the formula looks like this. FV equals PV times 1 plus I, the power of n. In this formula, the subscript n refers to the number of interest compounding periods that will occur during the time period you are calculating for. Determining the future value of an asset can become complicated depending on the type of asset. Also, the future value calculation is based on the assumption of a stable growth rate. So to understand the core concept, however, simple and compounding interest rates are the most straightforward examples of the future value calculation. There are two types of future value. First one is the future value using simple annual interest. With simple interest, an investment accrues interest based on solely on the initial investment amount. The interest that adds up as the year passes comes from only your principal amount, not the interest earned on that principal. If you are trying to calculate the value of an investment that accrues simple interest, your future value calculation will look like this. Future value equals to present value times with 1 plus R times T, where R is the interest rate, T is the number of years. Number 2 is future value using compounded annual interest. Note that the future value equation above calculates an investment future value with compounded interest, not simple interest. With compound interest, an asset earns interest on both the initial deposit and the interest that accrues each year. In other words, you earn interest on your interest. To calculate the value of an investment that accrues compounded interest is future value, which is FV, equals to present value times with 1 plus I to the power of n. So this is one of the simple annual interest example. Let's say Sally receives 1,500 from a relative and decides to put in a saving account that earns 15% simple annual interest each year. And she wants to know how much this investment will be worth in 5 years. So to do this, she used the following feature value formula to perform her calculation. So what she does is future value is equals to 1,500 times with 1 plus 0.5 times 5, and she gets 1,500 times 1 plus 0.75, and according to this calculation, the future value of Sally's 1,500 investment will be worth $2,625 after 5 years. So that's it, the future value after 5 years, simple annual interest. Okay, and then let's go to the compounded annual interest example. And let's assume that Sally also decides to put her 1,500 in a bank account that offers a 50% compounded interest instead. And again, she wants to learn the future value of that investment after 5 years. So she needs to adjust the future value formula to perform this calculation. So she did this. Future value is equals to $1,500 times with 1 plus 0.5 to the power of 5, and she gets 1,500 times 1.15 to the power of 5. And according to these calculations, the future value of Sally's $1,500 in the compounded interest account will be valued at about 3,017 ringgit, $17.04, and after 5 years, that is the worth of compounded annual interest. And that's all about future value. So thank you so much.
Hi, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Wan Nurul Afida binti Wan Zulkifli. My matric number is 1200901. So I will present about the annuity. An annuity is best defined as a finite series of payments made at specific intervals over a given time period. We regard fixed periods of time to be of equal length, and we refer to the amount of time as the payment period. For example, is the depositing of $100 in a saving account every 3 months for a year. There are two types of annuity, which is ordinary annuity and annuity due. Ordinary annuity is a series of periodic payments such as monthly or quarterly that are made at the end of each period, while annuity due refers to a series of equal payments made at the start of each period at the same interval. There are two formulas that we can use to calculate annuity present value. For ordinary annuity, we use formula P multiplied by in bracket 1 minus in bracket 1 plus R to the power of negative N divided by R. While for annuity due, we use the formula P multiplied by in bracket 1 plus R to the power of N minus 1 divided by R. P here refers to periodic payments and R refers to rate of interest per period, and lastly N refers to number of periods. So here is the example of ordinary annuity. The question asks us to find the present value, so we use the formula and then compute the value into the formula. $100 here is the R, the periodic payment, while N is 42, where 3.5 years multiplied by 12 months, and lastly, R is 6% divided by 12 equal to 0.005 because it is compounded monthly. So the final answer we will get $3,779.83. Next example of annuity due. The question asks to find the present value of annuity. So we insert all the values into the formula. R here refers to periodic payment, which is $50. Then N is the number of period, which is 3 years multiplied by 4 because it is compounded quarterly. So the value is 12, and lastly R, the interest rate is 6% divided by 4 equal to 0.015 because it is compounded quarterly. Then the final answer is $652.06.
My name is Nurhanis Mirza binti Khairul Anwar. My metric number 1200903. First of all, definition of amortization. Amortization is the installment payment of the loan and the process of writing down the value of either a loan or intangible asset. In this topic, there are some important terms that we will come across. That is principal, which is the original amount of loan. Second, interest, which is the amount the lenders charge. And lastly, amortized loan, which is a loan which the principal and interest are paid each period by making equal payments. To calculate amortization, there are several ways, such as using a given formula that is manually. Second, we can use amortization calculator. And the last method that can be used is using Excel template that have amortization formula. Now, let's look at example question. A salaried person took a home loan from a bank of $100,000 at the rate of interest of 10% for a period of 20 years. Now, we have to calculate the EMI amount, which is monthly payment and interest component paid to the bank. From information given, we get P, principal $100,000, R, rate of interest 10%, T, time 20 years, and N, monthly payment 12 months. For question A, amortization is calculated using below formula, and we get money payment is $965.02. For question B, to calculate interest paid, we will put value in interest formula, and we get interest, which is $131,605.02. So, interest paid on loan is $131,605.02. There are also questions that require us to prepare an amortization schedule. So let's see about amortization schedule. Amortization schedule is a schedule that shows the annual interest expense, the reduction of principal each year, and the ending balance or remaining principal of amortized loan. Let's look at an example of problem involving a amortization schedule. The question is, a person has taken the auto loan of $200,000 with the rate of interest 9% for the tenure of 3 years, and he wants to prepare his amortization schedule. In preparing the amortization schedule, there are 5 steps. First step, in 0 month column, put balance as $200,000 and then put 1, 2, 3 and so on till last month of money payment in the month fee. Second step, we need to calculate money payment amount using formula in the slide before this. Third step, we need to calculate principal, which is money payment minus interest portion. Next, calculate interest. The formula is I equals to PRT. And last step, calculate balance, which is previous balance minus principal.
What is an effective rate? The effective rate is the real return on a savings account or any interest-paying investment when the effects of compounding over time are taken into account. It also reveals the real percentage rate owed in interest on a loan, a credit card, or any other debt. We need to remember that the more frequent the compounding periods, the greater the return. The effective rate is an important financial concept to understand, and we can compare various offers accurately only if we know the effective annual interest rates of each. It's also known as the annual equivalent rate, effective interest rate, or effective annual interest rate. We can see here the formula for the effective rate is R equal to 1 plus I divided by n, then to the power of n minus 1. R here refers to the effective rate, I is nominal interest rate, and n represents the number of period. Now, let's take a look at an example of effective rate. Consider these two offers. Investment A pays 10.2% interest compounded semi-annually, and investment B pays 10.1% compounded monthly. Which one is the better offer? In this case, the advertised interest rate is the nominal interest rate. The effective rate is calculated by adjusting the nominal interest rate for the number of compounding periods the financial product will experience in a period of time. In this case, that period is 1 year. Let's look at the calculation shown below. For investment A, the answer would be 10.46%. And how we got this answer? We just put the information from the equation into the formula. In a bracket, 1 plus 10.2% divided by 2, then to the power of 2 minus 1. And same goes for investment B. In a bracket, 1 plus 10.1% divided by 12, then to the power of 12 minus 1. The answer would be 10.58%. From this example, we can conclude that investment A has a higher stated nominal interest rate, but the effective annual interest rate is lower than the effective rate for investment B. This is because investment A compounds fewer times over the course of the year. For that reason, effective rate can help investors to make the right decisions in investment. So, for these questions, investment B is better than investment A.